to some extent, when something bad happens to us, the more we are attached to something, the more that consumes our vision. So we just can't think of anything other than that attachment. And because we can't think of anything other than that attachment, so even if it is temporary, we can't let go of it. Suppose there is a sports match. Say there is India-Pakistan match. And you know, there's a very intense, tough match, and say one particular team loses. Now, some players in that team may say, that's terrible. They were devastated. They just sink down in gloom. And some others may say, it's just a match. It's a match. They had a better day than us, so they won. Whatever. So now you'll see that. Now some people may say, this is the end of the world. How could we have lost this match? Some others may say, okay, yeah, we really wanted to win, but it's after all a game. It's a match. No need to catastrophize it. So it's a matter of perspective. But the more somebody's attached to winning, everybody wants to win, no doubt. But the more somebody's consumed by winning, the more it is difficult to accept if one loses. But if one is more attached to, say, playing well, if I don't win today, I'll win tomorrow. Okay, I lost this match, but maybe tomorrow's match I will win. Then it becomes easier to accept. So you could say that attachment shrinks our vision. So when the more attached we are, we just can't see beyond the present situation. Whereas detachment expands our vision. If you're detached, okay, yes. Now, this detachment is not giving up. I'll talk about that a little later. But this detachment is, okay, we didn't play as well in this match, or they played better than us. So let's move to the next match. So one way we can get acceptance is by recognizing that whatever has gone wrong is temporary. It may be terribly wrong, but it is temporary. Now, in the case of Ram, how long was he exiled? 14 years. And when Ram was consoling Kausalya, he said that, oh mother, 14 years will go away just like 14 days. He said, I'll go to the forest and before you know it, I'll be back. Don't lament. Kausalya was so devastated. She said that, actually, although I was the senior most queen, but after Dashrath married Kaikeyi, she became his favorite queen. And I was neglected and slighted. Because of that, I tolerated, I endured it all. And my hope was that I would have a child. And then when I had a child, after long austerities, I had a child like you. It fulfilled my dreams. And when you grew up to become such an illustrious person, illustrious warrior, illustrious prince, all my dreams were that you will become the king. But now that you are being exiled to the forest, again, I will experience all the slights and the neglects and the insults. I can't live here. He says, let me come to the forest with you. So Ram, first argument he uses is, that actually 14 years, it'll just go away quickly. Now, Kausalya says, 14 years? He says, every single day will be like 14 years for me. So I cannot live without you. Then, at that time, Ram tells her that your duty right now is next to you, my father. He says, my father, when I met him, I saw that he was extremely distressed. He felt betrayed by Kaikeyi. He's not sending me to the forest with joy. He's sending me with great pain to the forest. And when he has been betrayed by, one wife, if at that time he's abandoned and rejected by another queen, says, it'll be impossible for him to be here. He said, you need to be with him. So राम हियर गेव कैकेयी अ सेंस ऑफ पर्पसफुलनेस. आई सेड एक्सेप्टेंस कैन कम फ्रॉम थ्री लेवल्स, फ्रॉम हेल्पलेसनेस और पावरलेसनेस, फ्रॉम टेम्पररीनेस एंड पर्पसफुलनेस. सो ही हेल्प कैकेयी और अदर नॉट कैकेयी कौशल्या टू शिफ्ट हर विजन ऑफ दशरथ. That instead of seeing Dashrath, seeing that, oh, Dashrath is sending my son away, he helped her see not as a perpetrator, but as a victim or as a co-victim. That he is hurt by what has happened. In fact, everything that Ram does is amazing over there. After he is banished, he hears that. When actually that night, Kaikeyi demands that the next day Ram is to be coronated, and the previous night Kaikeyi demands from Dashrath, and Dashrath is so shocked, he can't believe it. He faints when he comes back and he sees Kaikeyi's cold, expectant eyes, demanding eyes. He realizes it's not a nightmare; it's a reality. And he falls at her feet and begs her. He says, you can take everything from me, but don't ask for this. And finally, he says that if you want Bharat to be the king, let Bharat be the king. But don't ask Ram to go to the forest. He says, what way has Ram wronged you? I can't live without him. But Mantara has told Kaikeyi that as long as Ram is in the kingdom, Bharat, even if he comes back, Bharat will not accept the kingship. And even if Bharat accepts, the remaining citizens will not accept. You have to demand as firmly that Ram should go to the forest and Bharat should become the king, Prince Regent. So Kaikeyi is unmoved. And finally, when Ram is summoned to that assembly, to Kaikeyi's palace where Dashrath is there, at that time, Ram comes and he sees his father is disheveled, is distressed. And when you come to a room, there are two people sitting in the room and there is some tension among them. You can immediately sense that. If two people are having a good relationship, they may just glance at each other, they may be friendly, they smile. But if two people are having a tense relationship, they talk about the other person without even looking at that person. Or they look, but they look with as if they want to burn the other person. So it's easy to sense if you're coming to a room and there are some unpleasant vibrations over there. So Ram senses this, and he's just come from a very he's come with the expectation that now he's going to be coronated, and it's a very cheerful mood in Ayodhya. And immediately he recalibrates what's happening. And then he asks his father. And Dashrath Maharaj is so shattered, he thinks the son whom I was meant to protect, the son whom I was meant to give the kingdom, how can I tell him to go to the forest? Actually, Dashrath Maharaj never speaks the words. And Ram asks, Dashrath just stays silent. And then Ram turns to Kaikeyi and he asks her, oh mother Kaikeyi, what is the matter? My father seems to be greatly distressed. Please tell me. And then Kaikeyi says that he has something to tell you which he feels will cause you great distress. And that is why he is hesitant to tell you. Steel yourself so that you can hear these words. And then he says, please don't hesitate. Tell me whatever it is. If I can do anything to remove the distress of my father, I will do it immediately. And then she says that based on two promises that he had given me long ago, he has decided that Bharat will become the prince regent and then the king, and you will go to the forest in exile for 14 years. These are two devastating news. But Ram stays composed, unaffected. And then normally, when something as terrible or as unfair like this happens, and we are supposed to tell someone, then we expect that person to protest. We expect that person to maybe counterattack also. So Kaikeyi is preparing for that. Now Ram will protest. But Ram says that, oh, Mother Kaikeyi, you know, I always treated you like my mother. And I thought you also accepted me like your son. But today, it causes me great sadness to know that you never accepted me as your son. Now, Kaikeyi may think that. Here he will say, you know, how can you treat a son like this? I treated you like a mother, and is this what how you treat your son? But Ram, when Ram sees that there's hostility, his whole effort is to decrease the tension. So he says, if you had truly accepted me as your son, then for such an insignificant thing as a kingdom, you wouldn't even have needed to go to my father. You could just have told me and I would have given the kingdom to Bharat. Now Kaikeyi is shocked. Now, what is this? Is the more, see, if we are materialistic, we think that everyone else is materialistic. If we are power hungry, we think that everyone else is power hungry. And she just can't compute. How can anybody think like this? Is there some false move, some trick over here? Interesting. And he says, then he turns to his father. Oh, father, I'll prepare now to go to the forest. And before leaving, I'll come and take your blessings. And very calmly, Ram walks out of it. And as he walks out, he's come in the royal chariot. But he walks out on foot. And he goes towards his own palace. And when he goes there, everybody is puzzled. The courtiers who had come with him. And then this kind of news can't stay hidden for long. Yeah. It is said that walls have ears. And palace walls have very big ears. So whatever happens in a palace, in the smallest of things, there are so many people who are ready to tell about it. So the news starts spreading everywhere. And of course, people tell each other, but nobody tells it to the directly affected parties. So Sita, Lakshman, Kaushalya, all of them, Ram himself has to tell it. And throughout it all, what Ram does is, that instead of saying, you know, what unfair thing has happened to me? How dare something like this happen to me? This is so outrageous. He basically just helps everybody to come to a level of acceptance for it. He accepts it and he helps everyone to come to the level of acceptance.